About 11 years ago, I was sitting in my room at 4 a.m. trying not to wake anyone up while I stared at my phone screen. And no, I was not scrolling social media. I was actually coding on a keypad phone. One of those phones where you have to press 7-4 times just to type out S. I actually remember that night really well because honestly, I almost quit after what felt like forever just typing out JavaScript on this tiny screen. My code was not working again. There was no fancy error messages, no ChatGPT to turn to, no mentor I could ask. It was just me sitting there in the dark, wondering if I was just fooling myself thinking I could ever become a developer. If you're learning to code right now, whether you're watching this on some high-end MacBook or maybe a borrowed laptop, just as I was at one point, or hey, even on a phone like I did when I started, there's something I really need you to know. That night when I felt like giving up, well, it definitely was not my last, but you know what? 11, 12 years later, I'm here now, who worked at big companies like JetBrains, written 2 programming books, simplified JavaScript for very important programmers, and Git Prodigy. I launched several products, even created programming courses for LinkedIn Learning. And honestly, if it was not for those struggles, I would never have figured out what actually matters when you're learning to code. Now, ask yourself this question. Do you want to go through the next 10 years of struggle, or will you spend the next 5 minutes learning from my experience? Here's the first lesson. Your starting point is perfect. Let me tell you about Wapka.mobi. Sadly, it's discontinued now, but it was this simple platform I used to build websites because that's all I could access on my phone. While other people were out there learning on actual computers with proper IDEs, I was just customizing these mobile websites by arranging elements and typing out JavaScript on a keypad. Every time I read a coding blog post that started with "first open your terminal," I felt it in my stomach because I did not have a terminal. I did not even have a computer, but I had this burning need to create things. And here's what that taught me. The best starting point is not some high-end MacBook or an expensive Udemy course. It's really just that feeling that needs to build something, to solve problems, to create stuff. Everything else can be figured out along the way. Now, when people ask me about the right way to start coding, I think back to those late nights with my phone and I tell them, there is no right way. There's just your way. Whatever works with your life, your resources, your schedule, that right there is your perfect starting point. Lesson 2 is pretty important. To become an expert developer, you really have to learn how to focus. I can still remember the absolute chaos in my head back then. I had all these PDF programming books I'd managed to download when I started borrowing a laptop and could get internet access using night plans, which were a lot cheaper then. You know, JavaScript tutorials, Python basics, Ruby stuff, data science and machine learning. I was just completely drowning in possibilities. Every morning I'd wake up totally convinced I needed to learn something new. I would be thinking, well, maybe Python is better for beginners, or maybe the money is in PHP. Should I be starting with data science instead? Am I falling behind because I'm not learning Golang? But the moment everything changed was not when I got better equipment. It was when I decided to stop scattered learning and focus entirely on JavaScript. Just JavaScript. It felt like I was missing out, like I was falling behind. But for the first time, I started actually understanding programming for what it is, instead of just writing code. Because here's the thing, when you focus on truly understanding one thing, you start seeing these patterns everywhere. You start getting why certain solutions work and others just don't. And most importantly, you start building this confidence in your ability to solve problems, not just memorize solutions. And that understanding makes it so much simpler and easier to learn other languages and pick up new skills later on. Now I know several other languages, but it's because I made that decision to master one first. The third lesson I learned, real problems beats perfect solutions every single time. Do you know what my first real JavaScript project was? It was this tiny script that just added a custom share button to my wapka.movie site. Not some fancy Twitter clone, not an impressive portfolio, just a share button. But the thing is, that button was solving my actual problem. And when it finally worked, when I saw my code doing something real on my website, that feeling beats any tutorial completion certificate out there, any course certificate out there, and I mean any of them. So stop waiting around to build something impressive. Just build something real, even if it seems way too simple, especially if it seems too simple. Now, lesson four is something I really had to learn. You have to embrace the struggle. It took me years of borrowing computers, reading through PTFs, coding on my phone, and battling with internet access and electricity to even power on my device, because I was in Nigeria, Port Harcourt, Nigeria to be precise. And in order to buy my first laptop, I spent a whole year just working and saving. And it was an 8-inch mini laptop, which I was very proud of. Many tablets and iPads these days are even bigger than that laptop. There were times when error messages felt like a personal failure. Times when not grasping a concept felt like a proof that maybe I was not meant to be a developer. But the thing is, those struggles were not obstacles to learning. They were the learning. When you can just copy paste from Stack Overflow or run to the internet every time you hit a bug because you can't afford internet access during the day, so you have to wait until 1 a.m. When you have to really understand why your code is not working because you typed out every single character by hand, that's exactly the kind of challenge that creates the best developers. This takes us to lesson five. The best code solves problems. The phone I used when I started had a tiny screen. Just a few lines of code were visible at a time. No split screen, no multiple windows, you know, no external monitors and all that. But this one constraint taught me to build small focus solutions. On that phone, I could not build complex apps. All those fancy design patterns were completely out of the question. Each feature had to really justify the time it would take to type it all out, or to use multiple keypad button presses to position an element in the right place. But that limitation taught me something pretty important. Code exists to solve problems, not to look smart, not to use all the latest features, just to solve actual problems. Remember the share button I made, which took hours to type out? The code was pretty basic. It was probably not even proper JavaScript by today's standards, but visitors could share pages with one click instead of copying and pasting URLs. And that's what actually mattered. Today, I have better tools, multiple screens, several laptops, a proper keyboard, but I still ask myself the same question before I write any code. What problem does this actually solve? The phone was not just some limitation, it served as a filter. It forced me to focus on what actually mattered, which was making things that work. I started this video by asking if you wanted to learn from my experience instead of going through 10 years of struggle. But the truth is, some struggle just can't be avoided. It's part of the whole learning process. What you can change though is how you approach that struggle. You've got to focus on something until it really clicks. Build things that solve real problems, even if they are small ones. Use whatever tools you have right now, not the ones you wish you had. The most important thing is that you just keep going, because If I had quit back when it seemed too difficult, I would not be talking to you right now. I would not be where I am right now. Every great developer, and this is something you should remember, every great developer you know has gone through these tough times. The only difference is they showed up again the next day. So whether you're coding on a very expensive setup or a basic device like I did, if you can master these lessons, you too can become a successful developer. Now, if any of this helped you out, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, drop a comment below and let me know what device you're learning on and what problem you're trying to solve right now. I'd love to hear a story. And by the way, if you're in your job search right now, one of the new products I launched is nextjob.work, which is a platform that helps you with your job search, you know, track, manage your job search, helps you generate cover letters, custom cover letters tailored to the job application that you issue me and all of that. You can check it out. I'll leave the description and I'll leave the link in the description below. But it's nextjob.work. Check it out. Let me know in the comment section what your learning journey is right now and what problem you're trying to solve. See you in the next video.